one-to-ones. This is 16 WAPT News at 10.
Special coverage tonight of the passing of Jackson Mayor Chokwe Lumumba.
This was such a total shock for us, and we just have to pray for our town.
We look back at his life, his legacy, and how people across the city are remembering him.
Tonight, special coverage of the death of Jackson Mayor Chokwe Lumumba, who passed away earlier this evening. The coroner tells us she won't do an autopsy because he died of natural causes. The official time of death was 4:55 p.m. Mayor Lumumba had been in office since July. He was 66 years old. Our live team coverage begins at Jackson City Hall with 16 WAPT's Bert Kays. And Bert, you talked with city leaders tonight. What are they saying about the mayor's death?
People are shocked here, Stephanie. Most people just didn't expect this to happen and were bowled over when they heard it this afternoon. It was a very somber mood. And the guy who's going to succeed him was also shocked as well.
When I got that news, I was headed to City Hall and in one of the roundabouts. And I just pulled over and said a brief prayer. When people call on me to serve, I do it from the best of my, to the best of my ability.
Within the next 30 days, the city of Jackson will set a date for the special election, which can be no later than 45 days from that date when we set. We go through the same election process that has taken place in the previous elections.
Still, you were very much involved in this campaign. You were close to him. What are your thoughts?
City's lost a great leader. In the short time he was in office, he had the people with him because of his honesty and his openness, and it's going to be hard for anybody to come and take his place. I don't think anybody can actually take his place.
We've been through this once before. But this was such a total shock for us, and we just have to pray for our town.
Chokwe Lumumba first came to Mississippi in 1971. I remember him well when he was with the Republic of New Africa. That's an organization that wanted to establish the six states of the old Confederacy in the South as a new African nation. They set up a capital at Bolton, Mississippi. I asked him recently if he still believed in those beliefs that he had back in 1971. He said he did not. He had changed. The country had changed. Back in those days, a black person couldn't get elected. That's all different now. I'm living proof of that, he told me. I think differently now. Chokwe Lumumba, dead at 66. Stephanie?
Bert, we appreciate your perspective. Thank you so much. So here's what's next in the search for a new mayor. As Bert said, Charles Tillman is acting mayor. The city council now has 30 days to announce a special election. And 45 days from that time, the city will hold a new election for mayor. So that means we should have a new mayor in the next month and a half. The late mayor's son and family friends talked to the media tonight at the hospital. That's where 16 WAPT's Tammy Eswick continues our team coverage.
In fact, our father has passed today, and we thank you for all the well wishes which we have received.
His son, Chokwe Antar Lumumba, somber as he addressed the media about his father's passing.
What we ask for most is prayers, for we believe in the power of the Lord. We do not have fear because the Lord has not given us a spirit of fear.
The power of prayer. It's the one thing that family and friends say Chokwe Lumumba believed in deeply. They say they'll use that to get them through this hard time.
Had the opportunity to get here and be with his son, and we had prayer together just minutes ago,
kind of hard for you.
Yeah, this mayor. Chokwe Lumumba was an awesome man.
We talked to State Senator Kenny Wayne Jones just after he drove to the hospital to see his friend. This is one of the last pictures they took together.
Nobody ever thought that it was anything that was life-threatening or anything like that, because all the meetings we had, he was good to go, and he was so focused on what his vision was for the city.
Canton Mayor Arnell Bolden called it a tremendous loss. A friend, colleague, gone.
I thank the city of Jackson. I thank you for giving my father the opportunity to serve this city. It has given him great joy. Great joy. He has enjoyed working for you.
In Jackson, Tammy Eswick, 16, WAPT News.
Governor Phil Bryant released a statement earlier tonight. He said, quote, Deborah and I are shocked and saddened by the news of Mayor Lumumba's passing and are praying for his loved ones. Congressman Benny Thompson released a statement. It reads in part, I am deeply saddened by the death of my friend, Mayor Chokwe Lumumba. I have known Mayor Lumumba since 1974. And he certainly garnered a lot of attention even before he took office. Scott Simmons is here with more on that.
Yeah, you know, he was a lightning rod, no doubt about that. You can't debate it. He often talked about race. He talked about reparations. And in the later years of his life, rebuilding the city of Jackson, literally from the ground up.
I have been in remission, I guess they call it, for since 2000. So I'm happy to say that, and I'm very prayerful for everyone who has had this condition to make sure that they recover from it. Right.
Chokwe Lumumba's battle with cancer had been often discussed in the city. He tried at every turn to confirm that he was a cancer survivor, but Lumumba said he was ready to tackle the challenges of the city of Jackson.
When I see debris, I have a real aversion to debris.
As I traveled the campaign trail with him, he tried to reassure me that despite his age, it was the experience that gave him an advantage in the job that lay ahead. He was a high-profile attorney who had well-publicized run-ins with judges that at one point cost him his law license for 6 months. He had high-profile clients, too, having represented the likes of rapper Tupac Shakur as he campaigned for mayor. His opponents realized he was gaining traction with voters. Lumumba's New Africa and Black Panther associations in his younger days greatly concerned his critics, claiming he was controversial, a man with a too divisive past to lead the capital city of Mississippi. He was born Edwin Finley Taliaferro, but changed that name to Chokwe Lumumba, in his words, casting aside his slave name.
System must fall. This is a corrupt system. There can be no bargain with this system.
You cannot win the election in Jackson, Mississippi, if you run it as an independent.
You surprised when people say they look at those YouTube videos and they get scared of you?
Well, they don't look too long then, because if you look at them long enough, I don't think that they can really be afraid of me. I think that certain people don't, get excited about views and things of that nature.
Have you become moderate?
Well, I think my temperature is acclimated to the situation we find ourselves in.
So help me God.
So help me God.
After winning his office, he embarked on a campaign to tackle the city's crumbling infrastructure. He raised sewer and water rates and convinced voters that paying additional tax was a worthy investment in the city's future. Major accomplishments for the 66-year-old man, whose name is now entered in the city's history books as the second Jackson mayor to have died in office in recent years.
And we talked about this earlier. Frank Melton died while he was in office on Election Day. Harvey Johnson won that race, that Democratic primary that day. Of course, Chokwe Lumumba defeated Harvey Johnson.
Well, Scott, you, of course, spent a good bit of time with him. Did he try to distance himself from that controversial past?
Now, perhaps to a degree, you have to say that. It was certainly a wise political thing to do, but he said he needed this to be an all-inclusive city. He admitted he had his work cut out for him on that issue, certainly in convincing his critics who wanted to believe that he had not changed, but he said that he had.
All right, Scott, we appreciate it. Thank you. Well, the news of Mayor Lumumba's death spread quickly. Many people came to city council chambers to give their support and to mourn. 16 WAPT's Jennifer Ortega spoke to some of them about what the mayor meant to them and to the city of Jackson. Jennifer, it's been a hard night for many.
Stephanie, people we spoke to say the mayor did a lot in his short term.
In his short term as mayor, he sent a clear signal that anything is possible, because his win was the most unlikeliest. And I think it rallied a lot of people around the fact that he was an underdog and Jackson is an underdog.
Many people like Tommy Mabry are deeply saddened by the news of Mayor Chokwe Lumumba's passing.
How do you feel about this terrible loss?
It's tough. It hurt me. It hurt me real bad. Mr. Lumumba was like a father to me. Like, every time something knocked me down, he was the first one to build me. He took me from when I was a troubled youth, and he brought me to an outstanding man, and it just hurt to just even know he gone.
They're grateful as well for the positive changes he brought to the city of Jackson.
This 1% sales tax, I was glad that he got that approved. I mean, he's heading the city in the right direction, and hopefully someone can grab the torch that he left and carry this city forward.
Some are already looking to the future, hoping whoever takes over for Lumumba keeps moving the city in the right direction.
Seems like whenever we get up a couple steps, seems like we fall back down. And I'm concerned about who else is going to take the seat. The wrong person? We're not going to do good here in Jackson.
And we'll just have to wait and see. Live at City Hall, Jennifer Ortega, 16 WAPT News.
Jennifer, thank you. The city of Jackson did release a statement that reads in part, "It's with a heavy heart that we inform you that our beloved brother, civil rights activist, and mayor, Chokwe Lumumba, has passed away." Our team coverage continues with 16 WAPT's Aslan Hodges. He actually talked to one of the former city council members, Frank Blunson, to get his perspective tonight.
Chokwe Lumumba's death on Tuesday left Jackson with nearly 80% of Lumumba's tenure unfulfilled. However, in his brief stint as mayor of the capital city, he did leave a lasting impression on his peers.
You know, I always say that it's how, not how long you live, it's how well you live. He had things at heart. I was so proud that seemingly it looked like he was going to bring the people together. He was really trying to make a difference in the city of Jackson.
Blunson admitted whomever has to take over for Lumumba will have a difficult task, but he's confident that the city council will pick an appropriate and capable replacement. Reporting in Jackson, Aslan Hodges, 16 WAPT News.
Lumumba is the second Jackson mayor to die in office in recent years, as we've mentioned. Frank Melton died of cardiac arrest in 2009, shortly after polls closed for the Democratic primary for mayor. He was at the end of his first term as mayor. Again tonight, we have special coverage of the death of Jackson Mayor Chokwe Lumumba, who passed away earlier this evening. The coroner tells us she will not do an autopsy because he died of natural causes. The official time of death was 4:55 p.m. Mayor Lumumba had been in office since July. He was 66 years old. Stay with 16 WAPT and WAPT.com for continuing coverage. We'll be right back.
Lord, we thank you, we praise you, we glorify you, we magnify you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.